Hello students, now we are going to start a new series of mathematics class 12th, and today we are going to start a chapter of matrix. See, what is the definition of matrix? It is the ordered rectangular array of numbers. Like we take one example. See, there are three bowlers in a cricket match. Bowler 1, bowler 2, and bowler 3. They all played two matches. Match number 1 and match number 2. Bowler 1 took 3 wickets in match 1 and 4 wickets in match 2. Bowler 2 took 4 wickets in match 1 and 2 wickets in match 2. Bowler 3 took 5 wickets in match 1 and 0 wicket in match 2. Now we can arrange this data into two ways. See, this is called column, this, and this is called column, this is row. In matrix form, we can write it as, say, A matrix, this is 3, 4, 5, 4, 2, 0. This is one method of writing. See, in column, we have taken match number, and in column 2, that is match number 2, and in rows, we have taken number of wickets. Now we can have another method for writing this. In this is called a matrix. This is called this arrangement of writing a group of data. It is called a matrix. This is column number 1 of matrix. This is column number 2. This is row number 1. This is row number 2, this is row number 3. And these all numbers, they are called elements of matrix. These are called elements of matrix, and they are written as A, I, J. I is the number of row of the element, and J is the number of column. So we can write A is equal to Aij. Aij means I is the number of row. It is the first row, first column, then it is A11 is equal to 3. And this is first row, second column. Then this is called first row, second column. It is 4. This way, what is the this number? Column 1, row 2. This is 2, second row. Row 2. This is A21. A21 is 4. So this way, we write the matrix as A11, A12, A21, A22, A31, A32. This is the element of first row, first column. This is the element of first row, second column. This is the element second row, first column, second row. This is the element second row, second column. And This way, we can say, take an example, let us have, there are number of rows are represented by M and number of columns are represented by N, and the order of matrix is represented by M cross N, or it is spoken as M by N. So here M is equal to number of rows, 3 rows, and number of columns, 2 columns, N is equal to 2. So order of matrix is 3 by 2. This is the order of matrix. Now we take one example. Suppose a matrix is this is the matrix. Now we want to find out what is the value of A32 element. A32, 3 is the number of row, third row means this is the third row, and second column, this is row number 1, this is row number 2, this is row number 3. Third row, second column, this is column number 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. Column number 2, row 3, column 2, this is the A32. Let us say A24. A24 means the element which is present at second row and fourth column. Second row, fourth column, this is the element. So this is how we represent a number element in a matrix. And what is the order of this matrix? To find the order, we can represent the order by M by N. M is the number of row. Number of row is 3, and number of column 4. There are 4 columns. So 3 by 4 is the order of the matrix. Now, we see that if a matrix, how many number of elements are there in this matrix? There are 3 rows and 4 columns, then the number of elements will be 12. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 3 into 4, we multiply by number of rows and number of columns, then we get the total number of elements. Now we do one question. If a matrix has 20 elements, then how many rows and columns are possible? See, M into N, order is M by N, then M into N is 20. Then the possible arrangement can be, if we have one, this is row, this is column. If we have one row, then we should have 20 columns. This is one possibility. If we have two rows, then we have 10 columns, 2 into 10, 20, 20 elements are there. This is second possibility. Three rows cannot be there because number of elements will not be 20. 20 cannot be divided by 3. So we cannot take 3 rows. Now we take 4 rows and 5 columns, This is the third possibility. And fifth possibility is 5 rows, 4 columns. This is fourth possibility. Then we have 6. 6 cannot be there because 20 is not divisible by 6. 7 is not possible. 8 is not possible. 9 is not possible. And 10 row is possible for 2 columns. Now 11 is not possible, and up to 19 there is no possibility of matrix. And if we have 20 rows, then the column can be 1. And again, the reverse of this, if we 21 and if we have, so these are the possibilities. If we have 2 here, then here 10. And if we have 4, so these are the possibilities. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 possibilities, 6 number of matrix can be formed with 20 elements. Okay. Now we see what are the different types of matrix. First is column matrix, column matrix is only one column. This is only one column. A and B are said to be column matrix because the order of this type of matrix is m into 1, where m is the number of rows and 1 is the number of column. This is called column matrix. Second is row matrix. It has got only one row. Only one row. That is, if we take C is equal to minus 1, 5, 4, minus 2. This is called row matrix, and its order is 1 into n. 1 is the number of rows. Here number of row is 1. And column is 4. So its order is 1 by 4. Now the other type is square matrix. In this type of matrix, M is equal to N. Number of rows are equal to number of columns. See, if a matrix is given by 3, 4, 2, 5. Here m is equal to 2, number of rows are equal to 2, and n is equal to 2. Then this matrix is called square matrix, where m is 2, number of rows are 2, and number of columns are 2. Similarly, if we take this example, 1, 5, 0, 4, 5, 1, 3, 2, 1. Is it a scalar matrix? See, m is 3, n is 3. Both are equal, then this is said to be a scalar matrix. Now, other is diagonal matrix. Diagonal matrix, this is the fourth type. Diagonal matrix are those in which non-diagonal elements are 0. All the non-diagonal elements are 0. See, if A is equal to 4, there is no diagonal. So, we can treat that this is a diagonal matrix. B is equal to minus 1, 0, 0, 2. See, this is the diagonal. This is diagonal from left first element to right extreme end element. This is called diagonal in a scalar matrix. These are all scalar matrix. This is scalar matrix. Scalar matrix are those in which number of rows and number of columns are equal, m is equal to n. So, the left extreme upper element A11 and the elements on the diagonal. And all other elements are 0. See, this is non-diagonal element, not on diagonal, this is 0, this is 0. Similarly, if we take A is equal to 1, 0, 0, 0, 2, 5, 0, 2, 0, 5, 0, 0. Then this is a diagonal matrix because all the elements are on the diagonal are non-zero, but other elements which are not on diagonal, they are 0. So this is called diagonal matrix. Fifth is scalar matrix. Scalar matrix is a diagonal matrix. It is also a diagonal matrix. This is scalar if all the diagonal elements are equal. See, minus 1, 0, 0, minus 1. Diagonal elements are equal. See, 3, 0, 0, 0, 3, 0, 0, 0, 3. This is all the diagonal elements are equal. So this is called scalar matrix. 6 is identity matrix. A scalar matrix it is a scalar matrix in which elements in the diagonal are all 1. Diagonal are 1 and all other elements are 0. See, 1, 1, 0, 0. These are all identity matrix. Now, there is yet another type of matrix that is called zero matrix. All elements are 0. See, this is zero matrix, this is zero matrix, this is zero matrix. All the elements of this is zero matrix. All the elements of the matrix is zero. Now, we have to see that question. What are the possible orders if number of elements in a matrix is 13? See, for 13, number of rows and number of columns, multiplication of these two should be equal to 13. But 13 cannot be divided by any other number other than 1 or 13. So there can be 1 row and 13 columns, and there can be 13 rows and 1 columns. So there are only two matrix that can be formed with the number of elements 13. So if there is number of elements are prime numbers, prime number like 13, 11, 7, 5, 17. So all these prime numbers, if the number of elements are prime numbers, then number of matrix, number of arrangement of matrix, we can have only two matrix. Now we come on to what is the meaning of equality of matrix. See, equality of matrix means that two matrices, A, Aij, and B, Bij, they are said to be equal if, number one, they are of same order, number of rows and number of columns are equal in both the matrix, and second is each element of A is equal to the corresponding element of B. That is, Aij is equal to Bij. For example, 2031, this is equal to 2031. All the corresponding elements are equal. Number of, they are same order, 2 into 2 and 2 into 2. Number of orders are same order, they are both the matrix are same order, and Aij is equal to Bij. What does it mean? A11 is equal to B11, 2, that is equal to 2. A12 is equal to B12, that is equal to 3. So all the corresponding elements are equal in the two matrix. Now we do one question on this. See, if there are two matrix that is given by x plus 3 minus 6 b minus 3, z plus 4 a minus 1 minus 21, 2y minus 7 0 0, and this is given, it is given that this matrix is equal to 0 minus 6 2b plus 4 6 minus 3 minus 21 and 3y minus 2 2c plus 2 and 0. It is given that these two matrix are equal. Then find the values of A, B, C, X, Y, Z. How can we do it? See, we have just studied that if two matrix are equal, then their corresponding elements are equal. See, then X plus 3 will be equal to 0. X plus 3 will be equal to corresponding elements. Let us say it is A, and this is B. Then corresponding elements A11 is equal to B11. It is equal to this. X plus 3 is equal to 0. X is equal to minus 3. Then X is, we have calculated X as minus 3. And see, B minus 3 is equal to 2B plus 4. B minus 3 is equal to 2B plus 4. Corresponding elements A13 is equal to B13. So this will be B is equal to minus 7. So we have calculated B as minus 7. Similarly, Z plus 4 is equal to 6. So Z has value of 6 minus 4. Z is equal to 2. This way we can calculate all the values of A, B, C, X, Y, Z. So I request you to calculate all other values by this simple method, that all the elements of A are equal to all the corresponding elements of B. This way we can find the values of these variables in the matrix. Now we do some more questions on matrix. Number one is, you are to construct a 2 into 2 matrix. 2 by 2 matrix, and given is that Aij is equal to I plus j whole square divided by 2. See, there are 4 elements, 2 rows and 2 columns. So then the matrix will be given by here A11, A12, A21, A22. This is the matrix. This is the standard form of matrix. Now here, what is the A11? A11 will be I plus j whole square. I here is 1, j here is 1. 1 plus 1 whole square divided by 2. That is 2 square by 2. 4 by 2, and that is 2. So first element will be 2. Then second element, what will be the second element? Same formula, 1 plus 2 whole square divided by 2. 3 square, 9 by 2. So this will be 9 by 2. 2 1 same, 2 plus 1 whole square divided by 2, 9 by 2. And here 2 plus 2, 4 square, 16 by 2, that is 8. So the matrix will become A is equal to 2, 9 by 2, 9 by 2, 8. This is the matrix. So this way we can form a matrix. If we are given the general formula for a element. Now in our next class, we shall study operations on matrices. Thank you for watching the video.